Che brutto quel fiocco, Dio Cristo, stona di
Stai
brutto.
zitto, è un
Dai,
gattino,
vedi,
sì.
vedi che ha trovato.
Che
Vedi che ha trovato? È ancora quelle di
schifo di
prima.
mappa,
Hai
regalo.
visto che ha trovato?
Ma
Raga,
perché
questi
sei qua.
Ah,
Io non vorrei tornare
gangster,
indietro,
sono tedeschi, due
cazzo,
inglesi.
no, sono
No, più che altro loro qua secondo me ci hanno messo in giro perché siamo del cazzo, sì. Non facciamo di prendere. Questi qua cantano della piccola di notte.
Hello everyone, this is Serenities here, back with an awesome video for you guys today. And it is time, guys, it is time for GanGStaRss versus Nox on Halo 5. It had to come to this, friends, and I hope you're excited for this awesome matchup, I certainly am. Now let me just fill in for anyone that's not aware, GanGStaRss and Nox are not the best of friends. They do not like each other very much, and this is an ultimate rivalry face-off again, just after my one with V-Blight. And I've got an awesome matchup here against in GanGStaRss POV. This is the first time you've seen him on Serenity's vids, so I'm very happy to deliver my bro GanGStaRss onto Serenity's vids. I hope you're happy to be here, man. I certainly am as well. But on this night of game, guys, we had some really good matches with Nox and the rest of his Italianos, some really good games played, and there were three in total. Nox and his Italian companions won two of those. The first one was game one on Eden, where we did have the lead for the first sort of half of the game, but we ended up choking, so that was unfortunate for us. We did have a really good strong start at the beginning of that game, just lost it. And we also lost the game three on Regret, Slayer by 50-45. We didn't have a single OS in that game, so did quite well to get that score considering that fact. But Robbio's just come back to Halo as well, so there's been a few like changes in our team, and it's a fairly new form team, this one, also playing with Ryan in this gameplay. So you know, like having said that, you know, we played extremely well against Nox and his friends because they've been playing for a while, and this is a fairly new team still because we haven't really fully got as good as we can yet on Halo 5. We only just started playing together as our God Squad, so some really nice opening plays from GanGStaRss there, some really nice snipes in the beginning. Really great plays from him to actually secure that and get some really nice kills down for us at the start. And also a great play to get the opening set up with, you know, controlling Blue Room as well. That was a really big bit of play from GanGStaRss and the rest of our team, so really great play to achieve that. So, you know, I'm really excited to bring GanGStaRss gameplay as well, because GanGStaRss is one of my best friends, actually. You know, I've really loved playing with this guy since Halo 4. You know, all of my Dutch companions, Robbio, Gamble and Nikolai, all really good friends of mine, and GanGStaRss as well, is the same up there. Just love playing with him, and you know, had some sway wins with GanGStaRss over the time, including this one. But you know, definitely, like, you know, always making sure I play with my boy GanGStaRss, and I always will. Just a great guy, and just really excited to deliver a gameplay on Serenity's vids for him. So as you can see, guys, you know, really nice plays from GanGStaRss in the beginning, and nice plays from the rest of our squad to sort of hold Blue Room as well as we can. Gives us a massive starting lead, and actually, like, one of our best starts to a Riptide Slayer on this map. But, you know, like I said going into this one, that it's going to really come down to a setup in this game. So I just said to my team that, you know, like, we're just going to have to hold Blue and just, you know, really play for time and just really play annoying, and we'll definitely get the win. So that's exactly what we do here, and you can just see GanGStaRss just really doing his job. All he needs to do is help out everyone else, you know, with securing where they're going to come from, you know, which entrance they might try and get us from, because that's what Riptide is really, guys. You know, it's just camping, holding the Blue Room basically. If you can sufficiently hold Blue Room and, you know, get some nice kill leads, you're definitely going to win on this map and game type. It really is just a setup map. It's not one of my favourite things to play, honestly, in Halo 5, but I thought it was nice to get a film of it. And that's a lovely snapshot from GanGStaRss there on his arch nemesis Nox. We're going to have more of that Eye of the Tiger coming in there. Some great shots from GanGStaRss there, as you can see. Lovely nose coat from against Nox. But no disrespect to Nox, you know, I love playing Nox as well. He's just, you know, my H2A God Squad teammate. So, but yeah, Nox did get me in Halo 3 as well with a little upload. So I think he remembers the one. So I guess that's a little bit of revenge. You know, having GanGStaRss POV for this was pretty. It's pretty like much revenge. So that's what I mean in the title. But really nice to get a gameplay of. You know, GanGStaRss just doing his thing against his arch nemesis. So, but I love both of you guys. By the way, you know, I love you, GanGStaRss. I love you, Nox. Okay, so don't feel any more, you know, underloved or whatever. So, you both felt the same. Okay, so don't worry about that. anyway, he's putting in some really nice shots here. You know, GanGStaRss was trying to get some nice nades up until the blue hallway, but unfortunately, it's going to be taken out there. But this moment in time, guys, you know, we may have lost a bit of setup, and GanGStaRss knows that, but just responding to my callouts, you know, responding to team's callouts, Robbie will call out Nox there, it's obvious. Finishes off the kill there. You know, just really biding our time. You know, we've got a nice, I think it's 13, 14 kill lead, so just really want to take our time with that. I think we had like a 26 and 10 start, so we had a really good start. And we just really want to maintain that massive lead towards the end of the game. It'll just make it harder for Nox and his team to come back into it. And I haven't really talked too much about the other team. They are really good players. I actually played with Nox again recently, and I've really enjoyed doing that too. You know, Nox is another one of my best friends. And I noticed that Razator, Ruben, and J2ME are all, you know, all solid players. So it's a pretty strong team of four guys, and all Italian players. So I'm definitely, you know, a good team of four that we're playing here as well. And, you know, to take it on with Robbie Orr, Ryan and GanGStaRss as well, what can I say? It's just it's a brilliant team. And this is definitely, definitely GanGStaRss is the star of the show this one, though, because he's just really delivered with the kills and deaths in this game. Unfortunately, most of us get taken out there, but some really nice plays from GanGStaRss just to finish off the kill. Managed to call out the guys that were weak. You know, I was sort of hiding down the doorway to bottom mid, so just trying to put shots from my boy GanGStaRss to clear that up. Some really nice grenades, and he's going to take out his arch nemesis again, Nox. Another bit of Iron Tiger comes in here, but nice play from GanGStaRss to get that awesome nade. That's great play. At this point, guys, you know, 39-27, so still maintaining a reasonable healthy lead. It's about 12 kills. So, you know, definitely going to want to, you know, just really hold that down. At this point, you know, we haven't got any setup. We can't really push the enemy from where we are at the moment, so there's no need to really do anything. We've got like 5 minutes left to play. You know, we can make them play for time. So we're just going to literally sit here and wait for them to attack us first, because hopefully by doing that we can get into a better position of where we want to be on the map, and, you know, like sort of take control of the game again there and try and get a blue setup. So that's exactly what you want to do if you're in this position. You're comfortable enough with a really strong lead that you could do that. So as you can see, like GanGStaRss and all of us are all just hiding there and going hee, they don't know our plan. But that's what we were doing in game. Like, everyone was just laughing for some reason, I don't know why. But there you go, GanGStaRss is going to be taken out there. So pretty nice play for him to weaken, you know, any of those players for the survivors that were left behind, because that's going to help them finish off the kills that we need for our team there. But GanGStaRss getting a lovely spawn, as you can see, right into the blue room, so he's definitely got a much better angle on the map now. We might have a much better hold of where to push and where to set up. I think GanGStaRss is a bit aggressive here, personally. That kill on Nox was a really nice play to get it, though. I think probably because it was Nox, he wanted the kill, but I think it was a little bit aggressive to push in the way he did, but I mean, he proved me wrong because he got the kill on Nox and I was able to clear up his kill on Razator. So I mean, he definitely knew what he was doing, but that was a really nice play actually. It turned out to be, you know, quite a questionable play in the sense like he didn't need to do it, but actually getting a kill and assist there, so that was really, really huge play for our team, you know, bagging us another 2 kills for 1 death, so that was a really nice bit of play. At this point, you know, just looking to hide bottom mid, because assuming we've got all the other ports covered, that's all GanGStaRss has to do, is just watch the bottom mid area. At this point, I think he realizes that I might be pushed in blue room, so he sort of moves out a little bit, which is a nice play. And just taking his time, really, you know, we've still got about 3 minutes left to play now. The scores remain sort of fairly similar to what it was. I mean, 11 kill lead now, it's a little bit less, but still pretty much the same amount of kill lead we've got on Nox on the rest of his team. And, you know, looking to actually just maintain that. So, as you can see, pushing into blue, it's a nice play. Again, DMR is really helpful on this map for, you know, long-range mapping when you're in blue room, I guess. They do have beam rifles, so we do have to be a bit careful of that. I'm not sure about that decision to look window. I mean, we didn't have top middle covered, so you know, it was a bit of a aggressive push, I think. But nice play from GanGStaRss to try and sort of make something happen there. But I think just need to wait a bit, you know, before sort of making a full commitment on that challenge. So that's a nice play. So at this point, just looking to stay alive before G can't stay alive from the second nade. That's a really nice nade by Razzitor. And we're just going to have to regroup a bit there. As you see, I'm getting some nice kills. But the rest of our team are dying, so we're definitely going to try and have to stay alive. So GanGStaRss is going to just, you know, wait for his time here and wait for us all to spawn so we can get a better, you know, sort of angle on the map. And I think at this point, like, after I'd got my kill, I was still, like, stuck on their side of the map, so I was just taking my time not to sort of rush out on them and do help GanGStaRss get the kill on Ruben there, but I'm going to be taken out. At this point, definitely way too aggressive there, but I think I think GanGStaRss was just hyped, to be honest, because he played really well in the beginning and played well throughout the match, but got a ridiculous amount of kills at the beginning, just decided to stay aggressive because I think it was the right choice in the end. I mean, it worked really well. The fact we had such a strong lead, we could, you know, afford to take a few sort of risky measures on kills. And at this point, you know, GanGStaRss was making a really smart play. He knew there was a guy bottom mid. He was just waiting for him to use the MP, so he knew he could just use the AR and just charge in there with the Eye of the Tiger, finishing off Nox and the rest of his Italianos in a really exciting second game of the three-game series. But good game to Nox and all of his Italian players. We will be back for you, Nox. We have not finished, so I look forward to the next matchups. And I think GanGStaRss will as well. But when our team's more prepared, we're coming back, Nox. Hey mate, this was Serenity's guys with some GanGStaRss POV on this awesome game against Nox and his Italianos. This was Serenity's guys, and see you next time. Bye guys.
Che schifo, ma che cazzo è? Sto gioco, è diventato cento.
Lui mette a scudo, ci siamo dati i pugni insieme, sono morto solo io. E mi fai anche su
cazzo. Che merda di mappa.
Che ritardato.
Io lo sapevo che era lì, sono io che l'ho picchiato.
Ma infatti adesso becchiamoli su una mappa normale, che li umiliamo questi.
Vabbè, incredibile. Amen.